Live from the Ring of Fire, Mike Papantonio.
Well, Santorum's out. Gingrich is broke. Ron Paul's still crazy as a loon. Rick Perry's still burning down Texas. He's gone. Michelle Bachmann, well, God knows what she's doing. That means Mitt Romney, at this point, he's a lock on the Republican nominee for president. And while the GOP, they might be happy that their long primary season's over, the American public is way less enthusiastic about Mitt Romney. Joining me to talk about what's in store now that Romney is the only goof standing from the GOP. Karl Frisch. Karl, how do you etch-a-sketch this, baby?
I don't know. It feels like maybe it's a game of operation, not etch-a-sketch. And every move is, you know, the giant buzzer. You know, the next thing that Romney's going to have to do is pick a running mate, and that should be fun for all of us. I actually, you know, was telling people, have you heard the joke about Rick Santorum dropping out of the campaign? And then it occurred to me that the joke was actually that he was in the campaign to begin with.
Okay, well, look, we started out, you know, in there. You had John Huntsman, okay? I mean, look, let's say the best they had. They had John Huntsman.
Right, he's my favorite high school dropout.
Right, okay, so he was the best they had.
Know.
I mean, he had a lot of money. I mean, Daddy at least gave him a decent education where he'd become an ambassador of China. I mean, at least, you know, there was something there.
Right.
Now, what do you do? What do you do? What do you do with this guy that every day is out there just saying something crazier, just something more bizarre?
Well, you know, Romney can't, you know, pick somebody that overshadows him, like McCain picking Palin. So, you know, I think he's going to be really safe with his pick. It has to be somebody with impeccable conservative credentials. Now, I happen to salivate over the idea that he would pick somebody like Paul Ryan. That's not going to happen. And, you know, you've had Sarah Palin and Herman Cain saying that he should pick, you know, crazy Congressman West from Florida. I would love that, too. But he's going to pick somebody who's already been relatively well-vetted, who's extremely conservative to appease, you know, those fears of folks in the party. My money's on John Thune from South Dakota.
Really?
If you think about it, he beat Daschle. He ran twice for the Senate. He's been vetted. You haven't heard much of him since he got to the Senate.
He looks like a Republican, doesn't he?
Yeah, he looks like a used car salesman versus Romney being like a Cadillac dealer.
Okay, well, you got Rubio in Miami. Of course, barnacles are so bad.
He just can't quite get his own personal story straight. But Rubio's the kind of guy that would overshadow Romney. I mean, the race would be about Rubio. A presidential campaign has to be about the top of the ticket. It can't be about the bottom of the ticket.
And that's what we saw with McCain, right?
Right. I mean, McCain picked somebody for obviously political reasons. The only thing that people will need to care about when it's a running mate is that they can be president if something happens.
Well, the wagon is circling around Romney. I mean, you've got Karl Rove. You know, he's got his greasy little fingers. He's had his, you know, his ugly little involvement in this from the beginning. He's, you know, well, as you point out in what you write, you know, his every time Romney does anything that looks like it might have some sense of accomplishment about it, it's utterly the big win. It's fabulous. It's, yeah, this guy's brilliant. What's that about?
I think Karl Rove was the first person in the conservative media to really start, you know, giving the you know, signals that we need to get this wrapped up. I mean, the Republican Party is very boring, understand. Since 1976, every ticket except for the last one has had a Bush or a Dole on it. And, you know, since 1964, every person that got the Republican nomination, save for two people, George W. Bush and Goldwater, have run for president at least once before getting the nomination. So they're not particularly gifted at picking exciting, dynamic, never-heard-for characters as the nominee. And I think Karl Rove being there to signal that we need to wrap this up and get it finished is you know, a case in point on that one. And now you're seeing it across the political, you know, the conservative media. You know, nobody seems to have told Newt Gingrich, but I think that has more to do with paying off his campaign debt than it.
I'm going to talk to Ben Adler today, and he's on the same subject you are, which is, you know, you have You have Romney that has to etch a sketch, reinvent himself. He was appealing to the conservatives, appealing to the evangelicals,
appealing to the tea baggers.
Now he's all of a sudden he's got to look around and say, "What in the hell have I done to myself?" He's surrounded by these lunatics. I mean, I see tea baggers all around him. They're going to come to his aid, though. They are.
Of course they will. They don't care who it is now. It's just about beating Obama.
Right.
But I don't think Romney ever has that kind of introspection.
Yeah, no.
He would be eternally conflicted if he actually cared about what he stood for.
Yeah, but exactly. Let me change according to what I need.
Right.
And I thought it was interesting that right now you see the circles, there's a circling of these wagons around Romney. Romney, again, says stupid stuff almost every minute, but then you got the Fox and Friends trying to help him. Play clip number four where Romney says that Obama lost jobs for women. Play that.
He has not created jobs. He's lost 800,000 jobs during his presidency. And by the way, do you know what percentage of those jobs lost were lost by women? Over 92% of the jobs lost under this president were lost by women. His policies have been really a war on women.
Okay, Carl, now this is Fox and Friends. You pointed this out. You've been talking about they'll circle the wagons. Fox and Friends, clip number 11, where they're trying to support this goof.
92% of the women, of the people who have lost jobs on Barack Obama's watch have been women?
It seems impossible.
Okay, that's when you have Fox and Friends that are trying to come to your aid, but they say it's impossible.
I don't know if the listeners at home know this, but the actual hosts of Fox and Friends are robots built by design for Roger Ailes. So when they don't say something that fits the party line, it's terribly unique. We might actually be afraid that they're developing human characteristics to be able to lie.
you talk about time and time again how the joke is on the Republicans, that Romney has struggled. He's faced these non-entities. I mean, just nothing politicians.
Oh, sure, yeah.
He's faced Ron Paul, Michelle Bachmann, Rick Santorum.
Forget the campaign started with Donald Trump as the front runner.
Exactly. Okay, so he's faced them, and he has struggled even with them.
Right.
I mean, and it's not, and Obama hasn't even had to, he hasn't even had to flex here.
Hasn't even had to flex yet. I mean, the attacks that have been waged against Romney have largely just been what you would do in a conservative electorate. This has nothing to do with how you actually influence the center of this country or people that would be willing to vote for the right Republican if they came along. That happens now, and if he couldn't survive the punches of these numbskulls that were challenging him for the nomination, I don't know what he's going to do when we hit the World Series of politics here.
Yeah, and as you point out, the discussion of this undercard, this vice president, I saw the Alan West thing. Hey, play 14 on Alan West where he's talking about Democrats being communists. Play 14 for Carl.
Legislature, do you think are card-carrying Marxists?
Hey, Carl, I mean, how do we give you any more to work for? You know, there's a few.
I think he really should be the running mate.
Yeah, but we give, I think of people who are out there on the funny edge of this, and always you have the right look at it. Sometimes you go through dry spells where I don't have a lot to work with. But don't you feel like it's almost limitless what you have to work with?
With this cast of clowns, absolutely. I thought the crazy train was over when Romney, wrapped up this nomination, but the tracks are just being built, and they go right through Tampa.
Karl Frisch, syndicated columnist, and he's a partner of the communications firm Bullfight Strategies. Carl, it's always fun to talk to you. Thanks for joining me.